Okay, children, now next topic is energy stored in a capacitor or condenser. Capacitor is also known as condenser. Now, suppose you have this capacitor connected to a battery or potential V. Okay, now as the potential will change, your charge will change. Suppose you have connected to 10 volts or some potential you have connected, capacitance is C. Now, initially, so total charge Q, capital Q, will attain in some time, some small amount of time. But initially, what will happen? In order to attain the total charge Q, there will be small amount of charge which will be attained by this plate, small Q suppose. So this will be minus Q. Now when more charge will come here, this more positive charge will come, this positive charge will repel it. So you will have to do some amount of work to store the charge. Okay. So in this way, when we'll keep on doing work, the total charge capital Q will be stored. Now all the amount of work done to make this charge capital Q will be the potential energy stored by this capacitor. So we basically have to find that. Now suppose Q charge is already there and we have to bring dQ charge here. So there will be small amount of work which you will have to do. That will be equal to V dQ. Okay. Now V can be written as Q by C dQ dW. Now total work done we have to find. So total work done is equal to integral dW. So it can be written as Q by C dQ. Now this dQ, why I have done this Q by C? Because this was dQ. So I converted V into Q by C so that C is a constant. Now Q is a variable and this is dQ. Now because this is dQ, limit for charge will be from zero charge to total charge capital Q. Okay, C is a constant, can be taken outside, integral Q dQ 0 to Q. Now you know that integral x dx is equal to x square by 2. So Q dQ integral will be Q square by 2. So this work done will become 1 by C Q square by 2 0 to capital Q. Now 1 by C and 2 will take outside. What is left? Upper limit when you will put, you will get capital Q square minus 0. So you will get Q square by 2C. So here, so this is work done. So this is also potential energy U. Potential energy symbol is U. So potential energy here we got is Q square by 2C. But we know that Q is equal to CV. So when you will substitute the CV here, C square, V square, 1C cancels, you will also get half CV square. Okay, half CV square. Or when CV square may, if you combine 1C with 1C and 1V, the other V will remain outside. So you will get half QV. These are the three formulas for potential energy. Okay, total energy stored in a series and parallel combination of capacitors is equal to sum of the... Okay, now because of these three expressions, I can say that the total energy stored in series or parallel combination of capacitors is equal to sum of this energy stored in individual capacitor. So whether you have series combination or parallel combination, if you have to find total energy, you just add the individual energies stored. Here also you add and you will get the result. Same result you will get. Okay. Same result as in there is no different formula. Same logic. Add the individual energies in the capacitor. Add the individual energies in the capacitor. We get the total energy. Now energy density of a parallel plate capacitor. Density, mass density you know is mass upon volume. So energy density will be energy upon volume. So energy density for parallel plate capacitor. Now in the parallel plate capacitor, remember the electric field is uniform. So whenever you have uniform electric field, what will be the energy density? Energy density is small u is the symbol. This will be total energy, total divided by volume. Okay, so energy we got half CV square and volume is area if the plate. Okay, half CV square area of the plate into distance between the two plates. If you remember parallel plate capacitor, I proved for parallel plate capacitor C is equal to epsilon naught A by D, where D was the separation, so A into D. Okay, so that D is the separation between the two plates. Now this half CV square I can just, you know, in place of C I can substitute this expression. And what I am going to get then, u small u is equal to half, c will become epsilon naught a by d, v square upon a d. So you see this a cancels, okay. So what I am getting now, U is equal to half epsilon naught V square upon D square. Now V by D, half epsilon naught V by D whole square, potential per unit upon the distance, see potential difference upon this distance, V by DL or V by L, V by R, that is equal to electric field. So this is electric field's magnitude. Half epsilon naught E square is the energy density. Okay, so energy density, it's not just between the parallel plates, but anywhere if you have uniform electric field, so this will be the energy density. Okay, if it is uniform, it will be constant. If it is not uniform, it won't be constant. But this is the expression for energy density. Now, there is a topic called common potential. Okay, so common potential, actually questions, numericals based on that comes in exam. Sometimes it came in CBSE exam also. So when you have two capacitor, okay, common potential. So if you have two capacitors, C1, charged to different potential, so V1. And there is another capacitor C2, which is charged to different potential V2. These two are separate. Okay, so what will happen? It will have initial charge Q1 equal to C1 V1, and this will have Q2 is equal to C2 V2. Now, now you connect these two. Both the capacitors are at different potential. Now, when you connect these two, what will happen? There will be shifting of charge from one capacitor to another till the time both comes at same potential. So remember, children, whenever there is a difference of potential, charge will shift from one place to another, and it will shift till the time the potential becomes same. So when you have this capacitor C1 and you connect to C2, this is C1, this is C2, there will be shifting of the charge till the time both come at same potential. So V and this is also V. Okay, so V and V comes, leave it. You just connect these two. Now, so what will happen? Now the charge flow till potential becomes same. So your initial charge will be equal to final charge. Your initial charge was C1 V1 plus. Okay, so the charge, initial charge C1 V1 plus C2 V2. Okay, and the final charge will be same. But finally, what they both are at same potential. So C1 V plus C2 V, where V is the common potential at which they come. So from here, what we get? We get V is equal to C1 V1 plus C2 V2 by C1 plus C2. Remember, I've taken V common. So C1 plus C2, that comes here. So we get common potential expression this. Okay, now what is the initial energy? Initial energy was energy of this plus energy of this. So half C1 V1 square plus half C2 V2 square we will add. What is the final energy? Final energy is the final energy of this plus final energy of this. So half C1 V square plus half C2 V square. Half C1 V square plus half C2 V square. Okay. Now, if there is energy difference, so we will find how much. So remember, children, a charge lost by one capacitor is equal to charge gained by other capacitor, but the potential lost by one capacitor may not be equal to potential gained by the other capacitor. Okay, now if there is energy, if at all there is any kind of energy loss, how to find? If there is energy loss, final energy will be less. So I need to find initial minus final energy, total initial energy minus total final energy. If I get a positive number, that means there was energy loss. If I get a negative number, that means there is no energy loss. So let's do it. Initial is this and final is this. I'll substitute these values. So I mean, here only we will do. So E initial minus E final is equal to, you see here, this thing minus this thing. So half C1 V1 square plus half C2 V2 square minus half C1 plus C2 into V square. Okay, now V is this expression. This expression I'll substitute here. So I'll get half C1 V1 square plus half C2 V2 square minus half C1 plus C2. And for V, I get C1 V1 plus C2 V2 by C1 plus C2. This whole thing will become square. Okay, whole thing comes in the square. C1 C2 square and here C1 C2, that one will get cancelled. Okay. only I'll write, otherwise it's difficult. Okay, so C1 V1 square plus half C2 V2 square minus half, this one gets cancelled, I get C1 V1 plus C2 V2 square by C1 plus C2. Okay, now we will take that half outside and take LCM. So half outside, here see, I'll write this step, C1 V1 square plus C2 V2 square minus C1 V1 plus C2 V2 by C1 plus C2, this is square. Okay, now I'll open this bracket, take LCM, so I'll get half C1 plus C2, this becomes C1 square V1 square plus C1 C2 V2 square plus C1 C2 V1 square plus C2 square V2 square minus this whole thing. Okay, so what is that whole thing? It will be C1 square V1 square minus C2 square V2 square minus 2 C1 C2 V1 V2. Okay, now this will get cancelled from this. This will get cancelled from this. And then what is left? Half C1 plus C2. And in bracket, C1 C2 V2 square, C1 C2 V1 square, C1 C2. Okay, so C1 C2 can also be taken outside. So what is left? V2 square plus V1 square minus 2 V1 V2. Okay, so now you see A square plus B square minus 2AB. It's like that. So this becomes C1 C2 upon 2 C1 plus C2 V2 minus V1 whole square. Whether I write V2 minus V1 or V1 minus V2, it does not make any difference because finally it is square. So this square will always be positive. This is a positive number only. So what I am getting, E1 minus E2 is a positive number, positive value. That means initial energy is greater than final energy. That means there is energy loss. Always there will be energy loss when you have two capacitors at different potential and you combine them so that they come to common potential. There will be always energy loss, and sometimes they ask find the energy loss. Then you at that time you have to find, derive this expression. Okay, and what happens to the energy which is lost? The loss in the energy appears as spark or heat produced in the connecting wires. Okay, thank you.